One of the most important examples of a series is a geometric series. That is, where each term is a constant multiple of the term before, and let's, for simplicity, do a geometric series that starts with 1. So pick a number r, our ratio, and let's look at 1 plus r squared plus r cubed plus r to the fourth, and so on. And let's start doing our sums. You know, the first term is 1. Then we add r to that, and we get 1 plus r. Add r squared to that, we get 1 plus r squared. And in general, Sn is going to be 1 plus r squared up to r to the n minus 1. That's n terms. Now, I'm going to use a sneaky trick to evaluate Sn, to find a formula for Sn. So we multiply both sides of this equation by r, and we see that r times Sn is r plus r squared plus r to the n, because 1 times r is r times r is r squared times r is r cubed, r to the n minus 1 times r is r to the n. And then we take a difference. 1 minus r times Sn is 1, and all these terms in the middle cancel, minus r to the n. And that means that Sn is 1 minus r to the n divided by 1 minus r. And this expression, the sum of a geometric series, of a finite geometric series, sum of n terms in a geometric series, is true no matter what r is. It's true if r is 17, it's true if r is 0.03. Now let's see what the limit is. So if we want to take this infinite sum, by definition, that's the limit of the partial sums, and that's the limit of 1 minus r to the n over 1 minus r. And there are four cases to consider. The first case is where our ratio is less than 1. In that case, as we take more and more and more and more powers of r, we get smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller numbers, and we get that the limit is 1 minus 0 over 1 minus r, which is 1 over 1 minus r. Now, if r is bigger than 1, then r to the n gets bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And this limit doesn't exist. This whole thing diverges. And the last two cases are the borderline cases. What if r equals 1 or r equals negative 1? Well, if r equals negative 1, this has no limit, because you get negative 1 plus 1, negative 1 plus 1, negative 1 plus 1. So we have, so this is the sum, 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1. And if we do our partial sums, we get 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, and so on. And that, it doesn't get big, but it doesn't approach a limit. In fact, since it doesn't approach a limit, we say it diverges. And finally, we have the case where r equals 1. And then when r equals 1, this formula doesn't make sense because it's dividing by 0. So we'll just go back to the original series. When r equals 1, we're talking about 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. And so our partial sums are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and of course that diverges. So to sum up, if you have a geometric series and you want to figure out what is happening as you take this all the way to infinity, the sum of the geometric series is 1 over 1 minus r if the ratio is strictly less than 1 in magnitude, so anything between minus 0.999999999 and plus 0.999999999. And it diverges if the absolute value of r is 1 or bigger. So for example, we looked before at the series 1 plus a half plus a quarter plus an eighth and so on. And that gives us 1 over 1 minus a half, which is 1 over a half, which is 2. That's the answer we got before. Let's generalize it a little bit. If we take any geometric series, not just starting with 1, but starting with any number, and then multiply that number by r squared, by r cubed, and so on forever, then you get a divided by 1 minus r if r is less than 1, and it diverges if r is bigger than 1, unless a is 0. The case a is 0 is just silly. It's 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0. Okay, so what does an expression like 3.33333 on forever mean? Well, it means 3 plus 3 tenths plus 3 hundredths plus 3 thousandths and so on. And that means that a is 3, and r, each term is 1 tenth of the previous term, so it's r is a tenth. So we get 3 divided by 9 tenths, and that's 10 thirds, and 3 and a third. That's kind of what we expect. We expect the 0.33333 on forever to mean a third, and this is why. No matter how far out you go, you don't get exactly a third, but in the limit you get a third. And 0.9999999 on forever, the first term is 0.9, and the ratio is 1 tenth, so that's 0.9 divided by 9 tenths, and that's 1. So again, 0.9999999 on forever is what it means is the limit of 0.9, 0.99, 0.999, 0.9999, and so on, and that limit is 1.